What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about installing macOS version 14 into VMware Workstation 17. So let's get right into that. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is actually get a copy of the macOS 14 app file or the image file. And the way that I did it is within one of my iMacs that I have, I'm already logged into that machine using my developer account. So I was able to upgrade that machine to the latest OS 14 beta. And then once I upgraded the machine, I opened up terminal and I basically did this. This is the first command that I did. Software update, fetch full installer version 14.0. And it started scanning for that particular version and downloading. Once it's downloaded, you're actually able to go inside the applications folder and you're going to see your install macOS 14 beta image file. From here, we need to create a DMG file and then convert that DMG file to an ISO file so we can bring it over to VMware, boot into that ISO, and install the operating system. So within terminal, I ran the following. We need to basically create a empty DMG file. And I gave it 20 gigs, make sure it's pretty big. I think you are able to do 15 gigs, but I played this safe and did 20 gigs. Running this command, hit enter, and your DMG file is created. Now the next command that we need to do is we need to mount that DMG file that we just created. So I ran this command, hit enter, it's mounted. Now the next command that we need to do is sudo. Now, go back inside your applications folder and the install macOS 14 beta, right click on it, and then pick show package contents. It's gonna take you here, go inside contents, go inside resources, and then select create install media. Select it, drag it and drop it into your terminal. This is what you should get. Now, after this path, we need to use the switch of volume and the volume that we just mounted together with a parameter of no interaction and hit enter. It's gonna want you to enter your password, so enter your password. Once you enter your password, it's gonna start erasing and configuring, and then you're done. Not yet. Now, the following command we need to run is we need to detach that install macOS 14 beta volume. So I ran this command, hit enter, it ejected it. We're good to go. Next command is we need to convert our new DMG file, format it into a CDR. So I ran this command, hit enter. This process took a while. Eventually, everything should finish and it should create your new CDR file, depending on where you dropped it into. And then the next command that we need to do is we're going to move that CDR file and then convert it to an ISO running this command and hit enter. If everything goes well, on your desktop, you should see your ISO. Now, next thing that we need to do is go inside this website and we need to download the Auto Unlocker version 2.0.1. It's the latest one, which actually supports macOS 14, which is pretty cool. So click on that zip file. And because I'm using Microsoft Edge, it was giving me a lot of problems. So I got to click on this and then say keep. More problems with Edge. So click on show more. Click on keep anyway, and it downloads. Now open up the downloads folder. Right click on that zip file. I have 7-zip installed, so I'm going to select it and then click on extract files. Click OK. Bam. Now, double click on that folder and we're going to right click that exe file and run it as an administrator. When you run it as an administrator, you're going to get the user account control. Just click on yes and it should launch this. Pretty simple. Just click on patch. It's going to start downloading and patching the VMware workstation. Once it's completed, it's going to give you this. So click OK. The cool thing about this unlocker, it actually backs up everything for you and creates a log file. If you get any errors, just look at the log file. If it doesn't work, you're able to use the backup folder and recover back to its original state, and you should be good to go. Now open up your VMware workstation, and we're going to create a new virtual machine. So we're going to click on File, New Virtual Machine. I'm going to click Next here. We're not going to mount the ISO file as of yet, so click Next. We got a new option, which is Apple Mac OS X. That's the whole reason why we ran the unlocker, to give us this option. So we're going to pick it. Click on the drop-down menu and pick your flavor. For us, we're going to pick Mac OS 14. Click next here. Give your virtual machine a name and then give it a path. I left it as the default. Click next here. Now for the storage capacity, I left it as a default of 80 gigs. So click next here. Finish. Done. Now it's time for us to edit the virtual machine. So I'm going to click on edit virtual machine settings. For the memory, I bumped it up to 8 gigs. I clicked on the processor and I gave it an additional processor, giving it 4 cores. And let's click on CD/DVD. And then click on use ISO image file, click on browse, and then browse to where you have that ISO file that we created together. Select it, click on open, click OK, and then click on power on this virtual machine, and you should see the Apple symbol. Let this load up. Eventually, you're going to get this. Pick your language, click on the little arrow to go next. From here, we want to pick disk utility, click continue. You're going to pick your VMware SATA hard drive disk. Click on erase. I left everything as the default to reformat it using an Apple partition. And then click on erase. It's going to do its thing. Green check mark, which is always a good thing. Click on done. Then we're going to select install Mac OS 14 beta. Click on continue. You're going to get this. Click continue. Accept the license and agreement. Pick your hard drive. Click continue and you're going to get this. Now this process took maybe about 1 hour to 2 hours. All right, so once everything is done, it's going to give you this. So you're going to select your country. Once you pick your country, click on continue. Customize the spoken language if you want. Click continue here. I'm not going to set this up, so I just did not now. Because I'm using a virtual machine, I basically pick my computer does not connect to the internet as of yet because I don't have all the tools configured on this virtual machine as of yet. So you're able to pick that and then click continue. Data and privacy, continue. I'm not going to do a migration right now, so I clicked on not now. Accept the license and terms and conditions and click on agree. You're going to get it again, so click agree. Enter your full name, password, and a hint. Now for me, because I was using my laptop was running out of juice and it kind of shut down completely, but it actually created the account. So when I was able to power my laptop up and start it up and start the virtual machine, I was able to get this display. So I logged in, but I got this warning because again, my laptop just basically shut down on me. So I was able to just either continue or cancel. So I cancel it for now and it logged me into my virtual machine. Now, next thing I need to do is install the VMware tools. So if you mount the VMware tools and just install it, the display will change. This doesn't happen automatically. The first time that you actually install the VMware tools, it's going to fail because it's going to want to install a plugin or an extension first. And then you actually have to go inside system preferences to allow the extension to install. And then you need to do a reboot. Once you do the reboot, reinstall VMware tools again, and it's going to successfully install with no problem. And then you have to do another reboot. And once you reboot, it takes you here, and you're able to log into your Mac OS 14 using or piggybacking or hosting your virtual machine on a VMware workstation. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.